Good morning students, welcome to math session. We learned how to multiply two proper fractions, a mixed fraction with a proper fraction and two mixed fractions also in the previous class, right? Now, in today's session we are going to learn a different topic. That is, children, do you know how to find half of 100 rupees? Do you know how to find 1/4 quantity of 1 liter? Do you know what is 3/4 of 1 kg? So in today's session, we are going to learn all these concepts. Get ready.
Exercise 6.3. First one is MCQs. Children, complete these MCQs in your textbook only with your pencil, okay? Let's find out. See, 4/7 of 7 is. Children, here you must know this point. Of means multiplication. Of means multiplication. This we learnt in simplification of expressions, right? Yes. So whenever you have the term of, you have to put into symbol. Okay. Let us start. See, 4/7 of means into 7. Then you know how to multiply them, right? 7 can be written as 7/1. Now you know how to multiply two fractions. 4 × 7 / 7 × 1. So while multiplying two fractions, if you have same number in the numerator and denominator, we can cancel them. Since both sevens can be cancelled. Okay. If same number we have in the numerator and denominator, in multiplication, see, in multiplication we can cancel them. 7 can be cancelled with a 7. So the final answer is 4/1. Any number by 1 means the number itself. Okay. Next, 3/7 of 1 week. 3/7 of means we know into 1 week. See, 1 week, in 1 week how many days? 7 days, right? So we must keep 7 days. Is it clear? Now, 7 can be written as 7/1. So you know how to multiply them, right? 3 × 7 / 7 × 1. We know if we have same number in the numerator and denominator, when we have into, we can cancel them. 7 can be cancelled with 7. So what is left? 3/1 days. 3/1 days means any number by 1 gives the same number, 3 days. So that means 3/7 of a week. What is 3/7 part of 1 week? 3 days. Is it clear? Next, 4/5 of 120. So in 120, what is 4/5 part we are going to identify? Okay, let's start. See, 4/5 × 120 of means into, right? And 120 can be written as 120/1. Now what to do? 4 × 120 / 5 × 1. We know 5, in 5 table we will get 120. How many times do you know? You don't know. Then no problem. Do division and check. In 5 table how many times is 120? Let us check. 5 2s are 10 and then 20. 5 4s are 20, 0. Now you tell me in 5 table how many times is 120? 24 times. So let us cancel. In 5 table 24 times is 120. In 5 table, 1s are is 120. So, what to do next? Whatever numbers left, you have to multiply them. 4 × 24 / 1 × 1. See, we know by 1, no need to write, right? So, I am not writing by 1 because by 1 means the number itself. So, if you multiply 4 times 24, we get 96. That means, what is 4/5 part of 120 rupees? 96 rupees. So complete these all MCQs in textbook only. So let us match these all with the answers. So 4 means first one is answer is option B. 3 days means option C. Here 96 means option C. Okay, complete these all. If you want, you can write these steps in with the pencil in your textbook. Next, second Roman. Find the following. Here, if you see, the first question is 1/4 of an hour. That means in 1 hour, 1/4 means how much time we are going to calculate. Okay, see 1/4. You know, half means into, right? So we have to give 1/4 into 1 hour. 1 hour means how many minutes? 60 minutes. Let us write 60 minutes. Okay. And then we know we can keep by 1 to multiply 2 fractions. Then what to do? 1 into 60. 60 by 4 into 1, 4. Now in 4 table, do you know how many times is 60? You don't know? Then let us do division. 4 ones are 4. And 6 minus 4 is 2. 0 comes down. 4 fives are 20. So in 4 table, how many times is 60? 15 times. So in 4 table, how many times? 6. 15 times. In 4 table, 1s are 4. 4 table, 15s are. So the answer is 15 by 1. 15 by 1 means 15 only. Is it clear? That means 15 minutes. So what is 1/4 of 1 hour? 1/4 of 1 hour is 15 minutes. Is it clear? Next. 3 by 5 of 1 rupee. Now we are going to find what is 3 by 5 part of 1 rupee. Okay, let us start. 3 by 5, you know, of means into, right? So into. For 1 rupee, how much pies do you know? For 1 rupee, 100 pies. Is it clear? So we have to write 1 rupee means 100 pies. So 100 pies. By 1 we know. We can keep by 1, right? Then next what to do? 3 into 100 by 5 into 1. In 5 table, how many times is 100? Where is in 5 table? 520 is 100. Okay? Now, multiply. Cancellation over. What to do? We have to multiply the leftover terms. 3 into 20 is 60 by 1 into 1, 1. That means 60 by 1 is 60. 60 pies. Is it clear? So, 3 by 5 of 1 rupee means 60 pies. I hope you understood. Next one. 5 by 8 of 32. 5 by 8 of means into 32 can be written as 32 by 1. Okay? So, we have to multiply them. 5 into 32 by 8 into 1. Is there any cancellation? Yes, we have. In 8 table, 4, 8 fours are 32, right? 8 table how many times? 8 fours are. 8 table 1s are. So whatever numbers left, just multiply them. 5 fours are 20 by 1 into 1, 1. By 1, whenever you get by 1, no need to write 20. So what is 5 by 8th part of 32? Suppose you have 32 rupees. In that 32 rupees, you want to find what is 5 by 8th part means 20 rupees. Is it clear? Next. Half of 1 liter. So let us find what is half of 1 liter. Half. OF of means into 1 liter. Do you know? 1 liter means 1000 milliliters. Is it clear? 1 liter equal to 1000 milliliters. So instead of 1 liter, we have to write 1000 milliliters by 1. So 1 into 1000, 1000 by 2 into 1, 2. And you know how to multiply them? Sorry, how to divide 1000 with the 2? Just you do normal division. 2 5s are 10 and then 0 comes down. Then 2 table, 2 zeros are 0. And then next 0 will come down. And then in 2 table, 2 zeros are 0. So in 2 table, how many times? 500 times. Is it clear? In 2 table, how many times? 500 times is 1000. So what is the final answer? 500 by 1. By 1, no need to write, right? So 500 milliliters. Now you tell me, what is half of 1 liter? Half of 1 liter is 500 milliliters. Got it? Next. 7 by 8 of 1 liter. So we are going to find what is 7 by 8th part of 1 liter. You know 1 liter means? 1 liter means 1000 ml. So what to do? 7 by 8 into 1000 ml. Let us do. 7/8 into 1000 ml. So by 1 we have to keep. So 7 into 1000 by 8 into 1. Okay, just now we checked in 2 table 500 times is 1000, right? So 8 comes in 2 table, 1000 also comes in 2 table. Let us do cancellation in 2 table. 2 table 4s are 2 table 500 times, right? Now, so 7 into 500 by 4. Children, again cancellation is there. 500 comes in 4 table also. You know how many times? Don't know? Then do division. 4 1s are 4. 5 minus 4 is 1. Then 0 comes down. 4 table, 4 2s are 8 and then 2. And then if you bring 0 down, 4 5s are 20. Now tell me in 4 table how many times is 500? 125 times, right? So, let's cancel. 4 table, 125 times. So, what is the final answer? Final answer we will get if you multiply the leftover number 7 into 125. We have to multiply them, okay? 7 into 125 by 1. By 1 means no need to write, no? So, let us multiply this. 7 5s are 35, 3 carry, 7 2s are 14, plus 3, 17, 1 carry, 7 1s are 7 plus 1, 8, 875 milliliters. So, what did you understand? 7 by 8th part of 1 liter is 875 milliliters. I hope you understood how to find what is half of a liter, 3/4 of a liter, and how to find 3 by 5 of 1 rupee. It's very easy. Whenever we have OF of, we have to put into and then simplify. Practice these all, children. Thank you.